What's up, guys? We are back for our final episode of the Golden State Warriors rebuild. We are back once again in the playoffs. This time we're starting off in the second round, going up against Devin Booker, Chris Paul, and my Phoenix Suns. So let's get into the series and let's look at how easily we're going to beat these guys, because we have an absolute god squad. So this is an example of what our rotations are going to look like. If you remember from our last episode, we're kind of keeping the same idea where Ben Simmons and Curry are splitting the point guard. And then really, we're going to have like three or four all-stars on the court at all time, because this team is kind of just stupid overpowered. So I know it's been a little while that I've made one of these. I just haven't been super motivated to really get one until a few days ago. Really, I just kind of suddenly got in the mood to make one of these. But yeah, this is going to be our finale, and we're going to be running through. This is going to be our last season. So I just want to say thanks for all the support. This was really the series that kind of boosted my channel up to its glorious 123 subscribers at the time that I make it. So yeah, I would just like to thank everyone who watched the series, kind of gave me suggestions, and really did all that stuff to kind of keep me going. So if you did like it, we still have about a month until NBA 2K22 comes out. And of course, for 2K22, I'm going to be continuing this series. But if there's enough people wanting, then just comment below on this video. Let me know and tell me if you want me to make another series or if you just want to hold off for the next one. I still plan on making them all in the same kind of realistic fashion and the same kind of style that we've been doing. So that's not going to change. So really, if you want another one in this last month or so, let me know down below. Suggest a few teams and we can do it. If not, I'll definitely be back with this series at the start of 2K22. So anyways, getting into this game against the Phoenix Suns, the only thing I really have to say is Ben Simmons is incredibly cheesy in this game. Just like going through some of these highlights, he literally plays like Giannis. Like, I really don't get who at 2K kind of allowed this, just because the combination of his badges, his dunking ability, all that, like, really just kind of makes him go crazy. Speaking of going crazy, Wiseman is getting the board and the and one right there. Back out again on offense, we're going to get the ball to Clay. He's going to hand it off to Paul George. Paul George, another player who I think is actually a ton of fun to play with in 2K. He has a lot of good dunk animations, dribble animations. I think he has a really good release. Overall, just another guy that's really easy to use. And Clay Thompson right there, he's going to get the three. And now we're going to go back to Curry. Curry somehow hits this shot as the buzzer expires, giving us a 5-point lead going into the second. Now we're going to have Paul George and Wiseman run a pick and roll. Paul George, he's going to pull up. He's going to green it. That gives us a 7-point lead now. Going back, Curry's just going to do a little shake and bake on DeAndre Ayton, and he has no trouble getting back there. And then the corner, AJ McGuire, is going to try and stop him, but there's nothing that we can do. The Suns are still managing to fight back a little bit, but I have a feeling we're going to start to run away, especially if Steph Curry keeps doing stuff like that. He's going to come back, and now we're going to find Jay Crowder, and Crowder is also going to get to hit a three. Not to mention, Crowder is definitely one of my like favorite bench guys to use in this game, just a really solid 3-and-D player. And then now Crowder to Wiseman shows that connection. James Wiseman has developed so much better than I ever thought he would. I really expected him just to be kind of another lob guy, but instead he's turned almost better than DeAndre Ayton in this series, so that is kind of crazy. Yeah, and remember how I told you that Ben Simmons was super cheesy? Like, look at how he's just getting to the basket so easy. Maybe it's kind of my fault for technically placing him at point guard, because like, the CPU just doesn't know how to guard him. And that right there, look at that handoff. That is not a kind of handoff that you see a lot of people pull off in 2K. Ben Simmons once again doing it, except this time he blows the easy layup. You know, that's not the first time that Ben Simmons missed up on an easy layup. But anyways, that is it for this one. We end up winning 148-105. This time, though, the Suns are actually able to beat us on our home court in Game 2 as they win by 9. But that one victory for them is pretty short-lived, as in Games 3, 4, and 5, we blow out the Suns in every single one, meaning that we're actually making it on to the conference final. Alright, so after that quick defeat of the Phoenix Suns, we're now going up against the New Orleans Pelicans. And for this one, I actually just decided to rope it into the same episode, because at the time, I figured that this was going to be a pretty easy victory for us, but I think the Pelicans actually ended up taking us to 6 games. They really just developed a lot better than I thought they would. Of course, Zion Williamson is Zion Williamson, and Brandon Ingram is a much better bucket getter than what I really thought he was going to be. But regardless, we beat them in 6 games, and we are once again returning into the finals, this time going up against the Miami Heat, led by Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, Tyler Hero, Precious Achiuwa, Drew Holiday, and Goran Dragic. So a pretty similar team than what we saw only just a few years ago when the Heat played the Lakers, except this time that they've added Drew Holiday, making them an even better defensive team than what they were before. So once again, let's get into it and let's start simming this series. I actually lost the footage of me simming one of the games, so yeah, my bad on that. But anyways, game one we won, game two was a blowout, game three once again is gonna be a blowout. Now going into game four though, this time the Miami Heat are actually headed up pretty close to us. Now we're tied 101-101 with 5.5 minutes left. So I actually decided to hop into this one to see if I can champion my team to the win. Paul George comes back with the big shot there, and now this time Steph Curry's gonna find it to Jay Crowder as Curry gets a bad double team. Here we're gonna try baiting Holiday into taking the shot, but he's actually gonna make it off the Butler pass. But then Curry's gonna come back and hit an amazing Euro step layup like that. Paul George has been getting a lot of touches here. This time we're gonna try and get it to Ben Simmons. Simmons is gonna bully Tyler Hero down low, and he actually is going to make the layup off of this, which might be more impressive than that play. Right here, we're gonna try and run a play to hopefully get us a three-pointer right there. Klay Thompson sets us a screen. For whatever reason, I don't shoot the ball with Curry. Curry gets the ball down low to Simmons. Simmons shoots an awkward jumper and misses. Then Bam Adebayo decides, screw it, I'll take it up the court. He gets it to Holiday. Simmons is trying to get the cheesy steal on Holiday, but that doesn't work. Somehow Curry's matched up on Bam, but then Bam somehow misses the easy lob, which probably could have been the dagger for this one. Now Ben Simmons tries to bully Drew Holiday. That doesn't work, so Paul George is gonna have to take it himself, and somehow Paul George is able to hit that. A very dramatic 30 seconds there where he possibly could have lost the game. Paul George is gonna play some good defense there on Holiday. He gets it back up to Curry. Curry's gonna try to put the little razzle dazzle on him, but because George has been playing so well, we're gonna get him the ball and he's gonna green it in the corner, and that gives us a 1-point lead with 24 seconds left in the NBA Finals. 15 seconds left, this time Holiday is gonna take it, and Holiday once again hits a big bucket. Now the Heat have a 1-point lead. With 10 seconds left, you know the ball has to be in Curry's hands, but Holiday's all over him, trying to shake it open. We can't really get it, but I'm gonna see Paul George. Paul George shakes free, and he is going to hit the open layup. Another lead change within the last 30 seconds of this game. But let's see if that can actually be enough to stop it. Holiday is gonna shake it open, but he cannot hit the shot. So we once again have repeated as NBA champions. So in only 2 years, with just a few major roster moves, we've been able to take a team that actually missed out on the 2021 playoffs, make them the 2021 and now the 2022 NBA champion. All right guys, so that's gonna be it for this one. Anyways, I'd like to thank you all for the support on this series. Comment down below if you want me to run it back one more time and create one more series with a different team. If we want to do one more try at a championship. If not, that's it for this one, and I'll see you guys later in 2K22.